accessing my mind palace like Sherlock Holmes. Whoa, look at all this storage. Hey there, my neuro nerds. Trace here for DNews. Now, we all know that our brains can store an incredible amount of information, a lifetime of memories, everything from the good, the bad, and the downright embarrassing. Up until recently, it was thought that the brain could hold only the equivalent of about 100 terabytes of information max, which, let's face it, that's a lot. But it turns out our brains may actually have 10 times that capacity. In a 2016 study conducted by the Salk Institute, researchers discovered our brains could store at least a petabyte of information. A petabyte is the equivalent of approximately 1,000 terabytes, or 1 million gigabytes. To put it another way, if you were to continuously play a petabyte of 4-minute songs, it would take 2,000 years to listen to them all. To-do list, check. Obviously, this unit of measurement is generally used for computer memory, not brain capacity, but neuroscientists can also use bytes as a useful comparison for our own brain storage capacity. So both elephants and whales have physically larger brains, but relatively speaking, our body-to-brain ratio is about the same as a mouse. So learning about how our brains store and process information can give us insight into why we seem to be more intelligent than other animals. When you experience something, let's say your first kiss, that experience is converted into pulses of electrical energy coming from your external senses, lips, nose, hands, for example, and your internal senses as well, emotional responses and heart rate. That electrical energy is then fired across the brain through a network of neurons until it reaches the hippocampus, a sort of memory data bank. Though some recent studies suggest that certain long-term memories might also be stored in the cerebral cortex. Everything we do produces pulses, thousands of them, every day, and each one travels across neurons via a specific gap called a synapse. And this is where this story comes to play. In that synaptic junction, neurotransmitter chemicals ferry the pulses from one neuron to the next as fast as possible. The brain has roughly 86 billion neurons, not 100 billion, only 86 specifically, myth busted. And each brain cell connects to at least one other, but likely more than one, meaning that there are trillions of synapses. The gap between the neurons, that synaptic gap, it's small, only about 20 to 40 nanometers. But studies seem to indicate that these synapses are crucial in the process of making and storing memories. To find out how, the Salk Institute used a 3D digital model of a rat's hippocampus and examined how synapse size affected brain capacity and efficiency. In doing so, they noticed something unusual. In 10% of cases, a single neuron had two synapses connected to the same neighboring neuron. They were sending two copies of the exact same message. Curiously, those two synapses varied in size by about 8%, and when it comes to synapses, size really does matter. Larger synaptic gaps require more neurotransmitter chemicals, so they're more likely to succeed in communicating their electrical data from brain cell to brain cell. That simple 8% variation enabled researchers to create mathematical models, concluding that synapses come in 26 different discrete sizes. Which is pretty exciting, right? Trust me, it's exciting. This size variation is almost 10 times what was previously thought, suggesting that more size variability means, in digital terms, synapses are able to process more memory, 4.7 bits more precisely. Previously, scientists thought synapses could only process 1 or 2 bits at a time. This is a small change, but given that there are trillions of synapses spread throughout the brain, the researchers calculated this 1 petabyte capacity. Now, before you get too excited, remember this study wasn't modeling a human brain, but a rat brain. And though scientists think it could translate to humans, they aren't sure yet. And some neuroscientists believe the estimation is actually low. Maybe we could store 2 or 3 petabytes of memory. It's a lot to think about, pun intended. We know you love watching DNews online, but DNews is also on the Science Channel. Amy and I share a minute of the best in science in between some other awesome programming. So check us out as Science presents DNews at 9 every single weeknight, Monday through Friday. You can use your Twitter to tell them if you want to have more of those episodes and tell us what you think about them. And if you have story ideas, you can tell us there too. You can find the show at DNews. You can find me at Trace Dominguez. Let us know down in the comments if you have some problems with your brain capacity. You want more? You want less? Let us know. Thanks for watching.